While the economic relations between Uganda and South Africa have grown over the years, South Africa is worried about the decline of their companies doing business in Uganda. Among the renowned big companies that packed their belongings and left Uganda include retailers, game stores, ShopRite, and power generating company Eskom. But what could be the main cause of their exit?
Some businesses close, new ones open up. So when we focus on those that have closed, we lose the fact that there is business mutation. So you start as a retailer, you end up processing pineapples because this is what the market demands.
Speaking ahead of a forthcoming South Africa-Uganda Trade and Investment Summit in Kampala, the South African High Commissioner to Uganda attributed the challenge to the high taxes charged by the Uganda Revenue Authority, which has crippled most of the operations of his companies. A delegation from South Africa is now planning to meet the officials from the Uganda Revenue Authority to see this matter resolved.
Challenges of tax, including the economic downturn that we experienced after COVID. So those are some of the issues that we will be debating and discussing at the summit and strategizing how we can work together to overcome those challenges.
The ambassador also made it clear that the visa issue is big on the agenda during the forthcoming summit.
There were certain security measures that South Africa requested from Uganda relating to the ID, relating to the passports that we have to ensure that there are those security measures embedded in your passport, in your ID.
They want South Africa to relax restrictions for the Ugandan business community seeking to travel to South Africa. She, however, noted that South African government also wants Uganda to repatriate all the illegal settlers from their country.
It was agreed that our government and your government will be meeting in October to look at how much progress has been made on these issues. But now the South African immigration officers are coming end of this month, which means they are even more eager to meet before this summit so that we can know what is going on.
They must care about who comes into their borders by scrutinizing who comes in. And when they do that, often we feel offended. But we'll do the same as Uganda, because if you don't do that, okay, we're a very welcoming country, but we also know that the country needs to create jobs for her people. So visas, for me, we should categorize. We should say those who are exporting, trading, or delivering services to South Africa, give them first entry.
The South Africa-Uganda Second Trade and Investment Summit will be held in Kampala between September 5th to 8th. Story compiled by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.